Welcome to the training module on case logs. We are going to log and view case logs today in this segment. So the first thing you will do is click on Clinical Case Logs under eClass. And then we can see here we have a couple of case logs that we've started and one that's been completed. So we can see here we have a draft and then we have one that's been completed. On the left side, we'll see here the ID of that case log, the preceptor's name, the rotation that you are currently in, the practicum or internship that you're currently completing, the clinical site, the chief complaint of that patient, their age, and the date. And then automatically case logs are approved once they are submitted and are not able to be edited. If you need to go back and update a submitted case log, please reach out to your clinical site coordinator so that they can reopen these for you. If it is in the draft status, you can simply click on the left-hand checkbox, click actions. You can either view, edit, delete, print. You can link them together or make a copy of it. If you're seeing several diagnoses that are the same, for example, flu or cold or well exams, then you could just make a copy of those entries and then update them accordingly with the patient demographics. Let's go ahead and add in a case log. So click this green add button, and then all of the general information will populate. The date, the time frame of the semester, the setting type, which would be where you would be seeing this patient. If you were seeing them outpatient, private practice, telemedicine, urgent care, wherever you were seeing that patient, you would select this. Your site would automatically populate if scheduled appropriately and correctly in here. If these do not automatically populate under scheduled, please reach out to your clinical site coordinator. The same thing with your preceptor schedules. The section number is going to be, again, your course number. So whatever internship and practicum that you are in, if the section is blocked and does not automatically populate, please reach out to your clinical site coordinator because they will fix that for you. Again, it is a hard stop and will not permit you to go past this point if there is not a section scheduled for you. So reach out to your coordinator so they can help you. Once this is completed, you can hit either save or next. If you are doing any group encounters, which would primarily be for the psychiatric nurse practitioner students, you could click this and it will remove the age population. Otherwise, you would want to put an age of your patient in here by years, months, weeks, days, the gender, race. If you want to ever go back and look and see how many patients that you saw that were not using English as their first language, or what type of insurance that they, if they were seeing a population of uninsured, then you could certainly add this. It would be more for a personal use later when searching for jobs. Sometimes they'll ask what types of patients you saw in clinicals. If this is 100% volunteer, if you prefer to do that, that's something you could do, but not required. On this section, you're going to put the type of decision making. So straightforward, low complexity, medium or high. Your participation. Ideally, we'd like to see that you are performing the majority of your clinical and case logs with patients. You would have some assisted and observed options, but ideally the majority of your time would be spent performed. What type of H&P? Their chief complaint, one of my personal favorites, squirrel bite, and the reason for the visit. In this case, let's do a follow-up. Then we either save or click next. Nice spell. Okay, so then our diagnoses. And you can just start typing. Bitten by squirrel. Then we'll add that. You can add however many diagnoses that your patients have in this section, and then you can either click save or next. And then the procedures. So whatever it is that you did. Ideally, you wouldn't be doing surgery. So we'll do rehabilitative services for this one. We're just going to pick one and call it good. And you can also add as many items. I realize that that does not go with a squirrel bite, but that's what we're doing. You can add whatever items that, however many procedures that you wanted. So, and then you can click save and next. And your programs do not require you to click any experiences, so you can completely disregard this section of the case logs. So just click next right through it. And then any patient notes that you want to put here, anything remarkable, anything that went on, anything to help you remember this patient by, check with your clinical faculty and see what their expectations are for this specific note area. Some courses and classes do require something put in here, and others it is optional. So please confirm with your faculty what they want you to put here. Once you're done, you'll click the finish. Submit for approval. Yes, we would. And then we can see it's listed here. So that is how you will log your case log. And if you wanted to copy that, you could do that. So we'll click here on the right. Click copy. And then we can change any demographics that we want. So this is all would stay the same. So you would just hit next. And then we would just change the demographics of the patient. So let's say that now we have a 30-year-old female patient. That we want to add. And then you would just click through all of the other fields if everything was the same. And then we're going to submit for approval. And then to go back to your main home page at eMedley, once you're concluded with any case logs that you've seen for that day, then you would click the home button. And that concludes our case log section.